Blake Griffin is one of the best power forwards in the game, combining unparalleled power with unusual quickness and his size to create matchup nightmares for his defenders. And in an encouraging sign, he made 6 of 7 jump shots in the Clippers' preseason debut, cause for rejoice because he seems to be using the hop a lot more than he ever did in past seasons. For more in-depth analysis of his jump shot and what that means for the Clippers, make sure to check out the fantastic article by Ben Dowsett over on our website. Don't miss it. At B-Ball Breakdown, we are the unofficial protectors of basketball fundamentals, and it's Griffin's forays down low in the post that have us scratching our heads way too often. We took a deep, deep dive into synergy to see how he's been able to get good efficiency numbers with his post-ups while consistently displaying such bad footwork. Let's start with the left block, where he's 67th percentile, which isn't great, but it is above average. However, when he executes a move where he turns over his left shoulder, his ranking sinks to the 51st percentile, almost exactly average, and here's why. On most of his post-ups, he takes an awful lot of time and uses a ton of dribbles to get to the point where he's ready to attack. When he turns over his left shoulder, he favors jumping off of one foot, which leaves him less balanced and explosive on the release. On this move, watch how he doesn't bring his right foot over far enough, leaving his body facing almost away from the hoop as he begins his jump. He has to fight across his body to even get the ball in the direction of the basket. Here's another example where the right foot stops short and he almost comically jumps in the air while his back is to the basket. Turning with his left shoulder, he is constantly looking to lean into his defender and create space, which then leaves him vulnerable to off-balance one-footed shots when the defender gets out of his way. Now, let's look at what happens when he turns over his right shoulder from the left block. His numbers plummet further. By turning over his right shoulder, he should be shooting the majority of his shots left-handed, but Blake is clearly uncomfortable in many situations with his left hand. Here's an example of Blake jumping while his back is still to the basket, twisting in the air, and then improbably hitting the left-handed hook, which unfortunately must encourage him to keep doing it. Here's an opportunity for a drop step with the right foot, but instead, he hop spins in place, jumps with his back to the basket, and flings the ball somewhere in the basket vicinity. These are the kind of shots we've seen him attempt his whole career to very poor results. Fadeaway shots like this must be set up with some sort of ball or head fake. Instead, he relies on his quickness and leaping ability to shoot a very hard step back 15-foot fadeaway, bailing out the defense. His left-handed dribble is also problematic, and watch how he'll drag his pivot foot and get away with it, and once he gets ahead of steam, he loses court vision and doesn't see help defenders. On the left block, his best method of attack is the face-up, where he can utilize a nice jump shot off the glass without dribbling at first. And getting right into his shot immediately is a much better look than holding it so long. When he dribbles with his right hand, he's much more comfortable scoring, but when he goes baseline, it goes very bad very quickly. Overall, Griffin is better attacking on the right block, and of the 22 players with a minimum of 100 right block post-ups, he's third behind only Dirk and Melo. And turning over his left shoulder from there has him ranked 72nd percentile. Clearly, it's natural for Blake to turn to his dominant hand on the right side, where he can utilize his physical tools and natural talent. You can still see lots of awkward footwork and off-balance shots, but his right hand is much better at handling in-air adjustments. He favors lowering his right shoulder into his defender to clear out space, before spinning back over the left shoulder and finishing with some sort of right-handed jump hook. Turning over his right shoulder on the right block is another problematic experience for Griffin, as he's ranked below average in this category. That said, he's rated a good 71st percentile when he shoots a jump shot, as this kind of turn naturally has his shooting elbow lined up to the rim, and his exceptional elevation allows him to get the shot off over most of his defenders. And here's a good example of faking before attempting the fadeaway shot. But when he tries to go to the basket over his right shoulder, his fear of using his left hand to finish becomes very evident, as he prefers to uncork a series of twisting, fall-away, off-balance, across-the-body, right-handed push-shots with little hope of going in against veteran NBA defenders, and even when he does try with the left, the results aren't much better. It's clear to me that when he attacks right off the catch, he's the most effective he can be. And when he is indecisive and pounds the dribble 6 or 7 times, defenses have a better chance of stopping him. If the first preseason game is any indication, it appears he hasn't changed his post-up game much, so I'd expect the same overall good rating, even though it's pretty clear he's very inconsistent. If I were a defender studying this, I would know to take away his moves back to his right hand until he proved he could be effective going toward his left.